What happens to a person who is put into solitary confinement? When you are placed in a dark, dank prison cell with nothing to do and no one to talk to, the first thing is boredom. The mind looks for something to preoccupy itself with, counting all the bricks in the wall, studying the strokes of paint over the bricks. It doesn't take long for the mind to start losing itself. Next, it's the stress position, being made to stand or sit in the same position for hours on an end, unable to move. Your muscles begin to seize up. You can't sleep or even remotely relax. The only thing that is running through your mind is the pain that is gripping you on all sides. You are battling your mind, but loneliness and social isolation has kicked in. Your mind wanders back to your family and loved ones. You are crying out for just someone to talk to. But when you hear the sound of boots battering the ground, you cower in fear, anticipating another beating. In a matter of hours, your body begins to shrivel from a lack of water. In a matter of days, your body begins to eat away at the muscle from a lack of food. No mercy or compassion is thrown in your direction. The chains around your wrists and ankles pull upon your raw flesh. There's no light from any window, and the day and night merges into one. This sounds like something from a horror story, but this is what happened to our Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salam, the one who the people of Baghdad have crowned as king, the one whom Allah has anointed as Bab al-Hawa'ij. Once a lonely prisoner in Sindhi, in solitary confinement.